Making money is easy. Do you believe that? Your level of success and how much you're going to have to work in order to get there are going to depend on your answer to that question. So today, I'm going to talk all about beliefs and faith. So I decided this beautiful location out in nature by the stream in the middle of the mountains was a nice place to talk about this. Now, I said that making money was easy. The problem is, what gets in the way are beliefs. A lot of people have disempowering beliefs that sabotage them from ever making money, even though it would be easy if they could just get around those limiting beliefs. Now, there are two types of beliefs you could have. There is faith, and there is doubt. Faith is the belief in an outcome that is favorable to you. Doubt is the faith in an outcome that is unfavorable to you. Both of them are belief. Both of them are a idea that you have about a future that does not yet exist. So both of them aren't real. Both of them don't exist. So both of them are kind of on equal footing as far as rationality is concerned. But I will make the case that faith is far more helpful, far more empowering than doubt. Now this is so important for you to understand if you want to be successful, because everything that you do depends on what you believe. If you think about it, your behavior is always based on a certain set of beliefs. If you did not have faith, you would be completely paralyzed. You would not be able to move. You take a step in front of you because you believe that the ground will be able to hold you up, right? You leave your front door because you believe that it's safe. You believe that there's no saber-toothed tiger sitting outside the door waiting to devour you. You have to have a set of beliefs in order to do anything in your life, and as such, your beliefs will determine what you do in your life. Now, a lot of people like to say, oh, I want proof, I want evidence, etc., etc., but that's just not realistic for living your life. When you step on the ground in front of you, you do not have any scientific evidence whatsoever that that ground is going to be able to hold you up, right? You're taking it completely on faith. And the way that that faith works is kind of statistical extrapolation. What I mean by that is that you've probably stepped on a lot of pieces of ground that looked a lot like that in the past, and every single time, they've always been able to hold you up. So I think about it this way. Think about if you step onto a big concrete bridge. It looks really, really safe. It's got giant bolts and big, thick cables that are holding it up. Probably you're going to feel pretty safe, and you're not going to have any doubts about stepping onto that bridge. Think of that as opposed to stepping on a rickety old wooden bridge. Think like Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom, where the kid's jumping up and down and falls through the bridge, right? So you're not going to have as much faith on that. Why is that? The reason for that is that the big concrete bridge looks like big concrete bridges that have held you up no problem in the past, where the rickety little one looks like the one that you saw in the movies that the kid fell through, right? So you are extrapolating from your experiences what is going to happen to you, and that will determine whether you have faith or whether you have doubt. And a lot of people, especially in the middle class, have a lot of doubt. And, you know, it's gotten to such a ridiculous extent that now a lot of middle class people actually will take pride in their doubt to such an extent that they are making it a part of their identities. They are identifying as skeptics and joining organizations such as the Skeptic Society, right? I mean, it's completely ridiculous if you think about it for half a second. These people are forming societies to show how proud they are of their doubt. It's the most ridiculous thing in the world, but I suppose that, I mean, if they haven't really accomplished much else, it makes them feel good about themselves. But the paradoxical thing is that, you know, they think they're being rational because they're doubting, but their doubt is completely sabotaging all of their chances for success. So really, it's the most irrational thing in the world, but it's something that is absolutely pervasive among the middle class, because we have conflated doubt with rationality, doubt with intelligence, doubt with being smart. And you know, it makes sense in some cases, right? When somebody sends you an email saying, hey, I'm a prince in Nigeria, and if you'll send me $1,000, then I'll send you $10 million of my lost fortune, you know, right? It makes sense to be skeptical in that case, but to just have this generalized doubt and to actually identify yourself with it is completely sabotaging all of your chances for success. So the biggest reason why people don't succeed is because of doubt. And the doubt comes in a lot of forms, right? They doubt other people. They doubt the opportunities, right? Somebody tries to sell an opportunity and they say, oh, that's snake oil. They're just trying to take advantage of me. Or my favorite one, they're just trying to make money. It's like they're trying to make money, so therefore the opportunity is invalid. Right? I mean, I wonder if these people go to the grocery store and they buy their loaf of bread and they're standing in the checkout line and somebody whispers in their ear, hey, somebody's making money from you buying that bread. And they throw down the bread and say, oh, well, if somebody's going to make money, then I'm just going to go home and never eat again. Right? I mean, it's totally absurd if you think about it, but this is the way that we have been brainwashed. If somebody is trying to make money, we think, oh, that's something horrible. Right? So, we doubt opportunities and we doubt people. Another thing that we tend to doubt is that we doubt that creating wealth is possible. Now, this is really pernicious because it's not obvious that creating wealth is possible, right? You think, okay, if I'm going to get money, I have to get that money from somebody else. So in order for me to get money, I have to take from somebody else. But it just doesn't work that way. I mean, if you think from the beginning of the world till now, how much more wealth exists in the world? That wealth was created. I mean, you can't just take from each other and create wealth, right? Think about an example. The guy who invented the dishwasher. Let's talk about him. I have no idea who invented the dishwasher, but whoever invented the dishwasher saved a lot of people a lot of time. If you think about it, how many hours a week does your dishwasher save you? Probably it saves you, I don't know, at least 2 or 3 hours a week. How much is that time worth? How much do you get paid at work? You get paid $20 an hour, $50 an hour. Say you only get paid $10 an hour at work. Then if you save three hours per week, that guy is earning you $30 per week. Think of that over a lifetime. How much extra wealth is that that just did not exist before? Right? Creating the dishwasher created wealth in society. And not only the inventor of the dishwasher, but the engineers who created it, the factory workers who actually put the individual units together, the salesmen that sold them, the retailers that carried them, right? Everybody is involved in this society-wide effort of creating value, of creating wealth. So in order to create wealth, you have to come to the realization that your creation of wealth is not taking from somebody else. It is creating something new. It is a win-win situation. So a lot of people have a very hard time believing that. They have a very hard time wrapping their heads around how that works. And so they never really put the effort into creating wealth because they don't want to be a bad guy. You know, they don't want to be stealing money from other people. They don't want to be taking more for themselves than they really need if somebody else who needs it is going to be left hungry, right? Nobody wants to do that. So you have to believe that creating wealth is possible or you're never going to be able to do it. Now, if you're enjoying this content, please hit the thumbs up icon, hit the subscribe button, and hit the little bell beside the subscribe button and choose all so that you will be the first to get any new content that I put out. I'm going to be putting out a lot of awesome content that you guys are going to really love. And of course, if you enjoyed this video, if you found it useful, if you think it would be helpful to other people that you know and that you care about, please share this video with anybody you think it might be helpful to. Now, probably the most pernicious form of doubt is doubting yourself. And there's a lot of reasons people doubt themselves. Maybe their parents told them that they were never going to make it. Maybe their teachers told them they were stupid. Maybe their friends told them they were annoying. Maybe, you know, it could be any number of reasons. A lot of what we believe is just what has been put in our head since childhood and really has no basis in truth at all. It's just mental junk that we're carrying from our childhood. And it creates self-reinforcing cycles, right? Because if you believe that you're dumb, if you believe that you're going to fail, as soon as you try to do something, well, you're not going to try that hard, right? And because you believe that you're going to fail, why are you going to put all of your effort into something that you don't even believe you can do? So you're not going to try that hard. You're going to fail because you didn't try that hard, because you sabotaged yourself. And then you're going to look at that failure and you're going to say, oh, see, I'm dumb. I can't do it. I can't succeed. Whatever your belief was before, that's going to reinforce your belief because your belief caused it to happen in the first place. So self-doubt creates these horrible reinforcing cycles. So the problem with doubt, any kind of doubt, is that you're just not going to put in the effort. I mean, to be successful at anything, it requires time, it requires effort, sometimes it requires risk, a lot of times it requires facing people's criticism, you know, being willing to handle social pressure from other people. Are you really going to put yourself through all of that if you don't really believe in your heart that you can succeed? Of course you're not going to. You might try, you might start, you might hear some inspirational speaker, inspirational video and think, oh, I can do that. And then the moment it starts getting hard, you say, oh, no, my teacher was right. I can't do anything right. Or, you know, my suspicion was right. This guy is just a snake oil salesman and his product doesn't work. You know, you're just, as long as you have doubt, you're never going to succeed until you can get over that doubt. So I want to hear from all you guys. Do you have limiting beliefs? Do you have doubts that you recognize are keeping you from success? If you do, leave them in the comments. And, you know, I'm going to do a video soon about how to, or probably I'll do a bunch of videos about how to remove those doubts, how to get rid of them, and how to replace them with faith, with empowering beliefs that are going to help you succeed instead of cause you to fail and to sabotage yourself. But for now, check out this video. It's all about a system that I came up with the other day for creating an online business that you could get set up in just a few weeks with no specialized knowledge. I created this just as an example of some way that you could be making a lot of money in very little time. And while you're watching the video, think about, is this something I could do? Think about how simple that is, how easy it would be for you to learn if you could just get rid of those disempowering beliefs, if you could just get rid of the doubt and actually start doing it.